he slumped down in his chair crying and sobbing, and most everybody in the house busted out wailing and crying and saying, "Oh, it's awful, awful, horrible!" And there was a most tremendous excitement, and you couldn't hear yourself think. And right in the midst of it up jumps old Uncle Silas, white as a sheet, and sings out,
"It's true, every word! I murdered him in cold blood!"
By Jackson, it petrified them. People rose up wild all over the house, straining and staring for a better look at him, and the judge was hammering with his mallet and the sheriff yelling, "Order! Order in the court! Order!" And all the while the old man stood there a-quaking and his eyes a-burning and not looking at his wife and daughter, which was clinging to him and begging him to keep still, but pawing them off with his hands and saying he would clear his black soul from crime, he would heave off this load that was more than he could bear, and he wouldn't bear it another hour. And then he raged right along with his awful tale, everybody staring and gasping, judge, jury, lawyers, and everybody, and Benny and Aunt Sally crying their hearts out. And by George, Tom Sawyer never looked at him once, never once, just sat there gazing with all his eyes at something else, I couldn't tell what. And so the old man raged right along, pouring his words out like a stream of fire.
"I killed him. I am guilty. But I never had the notion in my life to hurt him or harm him, spite of all them lies about my threatening him, till the very minute I raised the club. Then my heart went cold. Then the pity all went out of it, and I struck to kill. In that one moment all my wrongs come into my mind. All the insults that that man and the scoundrel his brother there had put upon me, and how they laid in together to ruin me with the people, and take away my good name, and drive me to some deed that would destroy me and my family that hadn't ever done them no harm, so help me God. And they done it in a mean revenge. For why? Because my innocent, pure girl here at my side wouldn't marry that rich, insolent, ignorant, coward, Brace Dunlap, who's been sniveling here over a brother he never cared a brace farthing for.